would be the solution that you would offer if you could wave that social, political magic wand? What would be the solution you would offer?
You know, you're right in that East St. Louis is not alone, that there are many other cities who are suffering under the weight of the same pathologies. But if I were to wave a magic wand, I would say dam the entire river. And so there's no one solution to be had. There is a complex set of them. And so, in other words, you've got to reverse the government policies that created and keep this kind of poverty persisting. First and foremost, you've got to recreate or reimagine what public education looks like in this town. You've got to recreate and reimagine what its infrastructure looks like. Businesses can't move in because, frankly, it doesn't have the electrical and the water grid to handle
You're
major
kidding me.
enterprise.
In East
No,
St.
sir.
Louis, really?
And he thinks the stoplights don't work. And so instead of repairing the stoplights, they've shut them off and nailed stop signs
So,
to
but you
the
raise
light
a
poles.
you raise a Goldie and Goldie Taylor is with us, but you raise a very, I take it all this is going to be part of your documentary.
Absolutely. Every bit of it will be a part of the documentary.
This is
That gun violence
amazing.
just didn't, yeah, gun violence just didn't erupt overnight. You
Right.
broke down a civilization for all practical purposes. You broke down families, you broke down institutions, you broke down faith, houses of faith, housing. There is no decent housing in East St. Louis to live in. If you or I wanted to move into East St. Louis today, where would we find to live? My younger cousin lives in a should be condemned house in East St. Louis today. That in any other city would likely be, surrounded by, boards and nailed up. But she lives there, and that's what she can afford. It's the family house that my uncle bought in 1969, dilapidated and feels like the floors are going to fall in. But that's what the housing stock looks like in East St. Louis.
And
The
I,
old block where I grew up, there were
yeah.
probably 20 houses on that block, four of them are still standing.
But I tell you what, I do have to go back to something a lot of people probably are very surprised to you, and that is the, like you said, the infrastructure
Yes.
is not there to even support growth. So if
Well,
a if
the manhole covers are missing. You can't drive down the street without busting your axle on your car. It has the roads have the look and feel of war-torn Fallujah.
And the social impact, the particularly the gun violence impacted your family, didn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And my immediate family, there are no grandfathers, no fathers, no uncles, and no brothers. And if you look across the family to older cousins, there are no old men in the family. And so in my immediate family, the oldest man is my nephew, and he is 27, turning 28 years old in July. But across the further part of the family, there are no 60, 70, 80-year-old men in our family. They are gone. Whether it's gun violence, heart disease, sickle cell, HIV, suicide, alcoholism, you name it, swept through our family, like a dry hut in a high wind. And so those are the kinds of things that we face as a family. But unfortunately, we're not alone. There are so many families in East St. Louis and other cities just like it, who are suffering under the same kinds of weight. I say that we are, unfortunately, a family of women.